Hi guys, this is Ravi and you are listening to me on the Nifty BN channel. I am very excited to bring you this video as it deals with a concept that no one has touched on yet. In this video, I teach you how to pull live option chain data into Excel from the new NSE India website. The most interesting thing about this method is that it does not require cookie authentication. This will be a multi-part series, so please don't forget to subscribe to the channel so you don't miss a new video. So without any further delay, let's begin the learning. Want to meet like-minded traders and discuss option strategies, adjustments and more? Just type in Discuss Nifty in your Telegram search box and join the friendly trader community. The first step in this method is to identify the JSON structure. But let's first learn what a JSON is. JSON stands for JavaScript Object Notation. It is used to store information in an organized and easy to read manner. It offers a human readable collection of data which can be accessed logically. It is also language independent. JSON can contain the following: array, object, string, number, and values. As mentioned earlier, the first step is to identify the JSON structure that we wish to parse. For this, go to nseindia.com, choose the market data section, and then click on the derivatives market link under Market Watch. Click on Nifty and wait for the page to load completely. Now right click on a name empty space there. Click on the Inspect option from the menu that gets expanded out. Now click on the Network tab and make sure the XHR filter is selected. Click on the Option Chain link. The bottommost result is what we are interested in. Click on Response and select all of the JSON text. With the JSON text selected, right click and choose Open in New tab. Now select all of the text on the page and copy the selected text. Now go to google.com and search for online JSON parser. Click on the first result. Paste the text here and wait for a few seconds. The JSON structure will be loaded to the right window. You should notice that instead of the records object, there is an expiry date key that contains an array of all the expiry dates. There are four other keys inside of the records object, namely data, timestamp, underlying value, and strike prices. And there are three keys inside of the filtered object, namely data, CE, and PE. Note that in JSON, arrays are denoted by square brackets and objects are denoted by curly brackets. JSON objects are written in key-value pairs. Keys and values are separated by a colon. Each key-value pair is separated by a comma. Now that we identified the structure, let's go to the next step. To help parse the complex JSON structure, we will need a file named jsonconverter.bas. Go to google.com and search for jsonconverter.bas. Click on the first result. Once on the web page, scroll down. Right click on Raw. Select the Save Link As option to save the file to our computer. Now to the most important section of the video. Open Excel and open a new blank workbook. The workbook opens with one worksheet called Sheet 1. Select the Developer tab from the toolbar at the top of the screen. Then click on the Visual Basic option in the code group. Right click in the Project Explorer window and select Import File. And select the downloaded file jsonconverter.bas. Go to Insert and click on Module to insert a new module. Go to Tools and References and check Microsoft Scripting Runtime. Now to the coding part. Start with the usual option explicit statement. Start a new subroutine called fetch option chain. Declare a few variables, JSON as object, web URL as string, I as integer, and expiry dates array as variant. Set the web URL value to the JSON link we identified in the previous step. Create an XML HTTP object and then use the open method to get a copy of the required JSON. Now set the JSON value to the response text property, which contains the entire JSON structure. Now to check whether we passed the JSON correctly, let's load the expiry dates array we noticed in the JSON structure into the expiry dates array variable and then print the values to the immediate window by using the debug.print statement. If we see the values in the immediate window, then we can proceed to the next step. To save and use the file as a macro enabled workbook, click the File tab and then choose Save As. The Save As dialog box appears. Select this PC. Select the Save As type drop down arrow. A list of file types appears. Select Excel macro enabled workbook and enter a file name. I called mine Fetch Option Chain version 1.0. Excel adds the .xlsm extension to the file name. Click Save. We'll be using the array expiry dates array later in one of our future videos. Let's declare a few more variables now. J and K as integers and header values as variant. For this example, we'll just be loading the OI, change of OI and strike price values on both the call and put side. So let's load only those string values into the header values array and set these values to the first 5 columns of the first row. Now let's use the forNext statement to load the values that we are interested in to the Excel sheet. Run the module and voila, we have successfully pulled the data we want into the Excel sheet. Scroll down to check if everything is alright, else make changes to the code. To prevent the macro from returning cached values, let's use the setRequestHeader method. This is an extremely important step, so do not forget to include these two lines of code. Cells.clear is the last line of code to be added to the macro, just before the header values array, to clear the Excel sheet completely before inserting the data. In the next part, we will see how to format and utilize this data for making trading related decisions. Thank you for watching. Please post any questions you have in the comment section. Also, do not forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel. To find us on Twitter and Telegram, use the username NiftyBN. Also, I post some of my trades to the community tab, so don't forget to check that from time to time.